Hi everyone, welcome to verbal ability training module. So today we are going to discuss error detection, right? As we have already discussed that error detection is an important part of verbal ability. So let us see how do we wrongly use adverbs at times. To modify a verb, an adjective or another adverb, we use an adverb. At times, you know, If we tend to make mistakes, like if I say the sentence, she writes very careful, it would be wrong. If I say she writes very carefully, it is right. Because careful is an adjective which cannot modify the adverb very, right? Therefore, carefully adverb must be used in place of adjective careful. So students, you don't have to be confused between an adjective and an adverb, because an adjective modifies a noun or pronoun, while an adverb adds to the meaning or modify a verb, adjective or another adverb. Next, to means more than required, and it is used with unpleasant adjective. So we cannot use too glad, too happy, too pleasant or too healthy. For example, if I say I'm too glad to meet you, that means I'm so glad that I cannot meet you, right? While you wanted to say something else, right? So in case of such sentences, we have to use very and not too. We have to say the sentence as, I'm very glad to meet you. A sentence which is based on to and to format, we cannot replace to with so that. If we replace to with so that, to must be replaced with cannot, right? So parallelism has to be there and we have to go for the correct format. For example, he is too weak so that he cannot walk would be the wrong formation of sentence. The right sentence would be, he is too weak to walk. Or we can say this sentence as, he is so weak that he cannot walk. Much too is followed by an unpleasant adjective, while too much is followed by noun, right? That means much too plus unpleasant adjective and too much plus noun, like we see in the sentences. If I say his failure is too much painful for me, it would be grammatically wrong. The right sentence would be, his failure is much too painful for me, because painful is an unpleasant adjective. So we have to use much too and not too much, because with too much we use noun. For example, his wife's rude behavior gives him much too pain would be the wrong sentence. The right sentence would be, his wife's rude behavior gives him too much pain, because pain is noun, so we have to use too much. Next, quite and all are not to be used together. For example, he's quite all right would be the wrong sentence. Either use quite or use all. We can say he is quite right or he is all right. Enough, when used as an adverb, is preceded by a positive degree adjective or adverb. For example, if I say he is greater enough to pardon you is incorrect, because greater is comparative degree, and enough, when used as an adverb, we have to use a positive degree before it. For example, he is great enough to pardon you. This sentence is correct because great is positive degree. Two negatives cancel each other. Hence, two negatives should not be used in the same sentence unless we make an affirmation. For example, if I say, I have not got none, not and none are two negatives which will cancel each other. So the correct way to say the sentence would be, I have not got any. At present means at the present time. At present is a phrase and presently means shortly. These should not be confused. For example, nothing more can be done presently would be wrong, right? Because I am referring to the present time. So instead of using presently, which means shortly, I have to use at present. Nothing more can be done at present. If I say he will come back at present, that would again be wrong, because here I mean to say that he will come back shortly. So instead of at present, I have to use presently, because presently means shortly and at present means at the present time. So we will say he will come back presently. Hard means diligently, strenuously. Hardly means scarcely at all. These two adverbial forms of hard must not be confused. For example, if I say he tried hard to win the race, this would be a wrong sentence. right? We have to say he tried hard to win the race. If I say she has eaten hard anything today, that would again be wrong, because what I mean to say, she has hardly eaten anything today, right? So hardly means scarcely and hard means diligently. So students, please don't be confused with these two words. Much is used before past participles and adjectives or adverbs of comparative degree, and very is used before the present participles and adjectives and adverbs of positive degree. For example, if I say the news is much surprising, surprising is present participle, right? So we have to use very instead of much. If I say the news is very surprising, it is correct. Next, I was very surprised at hearing the news. Surprised is past participle, so we cannot use very before it. We have to use I was much surprised at hearing the news. So what we need to remember, much is used before past participle and very is used before the present participle. The sentence which starts with seldom, never, hardly, rarely or scarcely takes an inverse structure. Inverse structure means we use verb before the subject and then rest of the structure of the sentence is followed, but the sentence remains simple. For example, if I say seldom I had seen such a beautiful sight, would again be a wrong formation of sentence, right? Because what we need to do, the sentence is starting with seldom, so we have to use seldom and then inverse structure of the sentence. Seldom had I seen such a beautiful sight. Use of conjunction. Two conjunctions should not be used in the same sentence. For example, although she was tired but she still went on working is wrong, because we have used two conjunctions in the same sentence, right? So we have to say although she was tired, she still went on working. Both should be followed by and. It should be used in the positive sense. In the negative sense, we use neither nor, right? In place of both. For example, both Ravi as well as Raja were present there. If I am already using both, I have to use and, not as well as, right? So what we have to say, both Ravi and Raja were present there. And what we need to remember, that both has to be used in positive sense. For negative sense, you have to use neither nor. No sooner should be followed by than then and not but or than then. Students, at times, students tend to get confused with these words, right? Because then is used for comparison. So if I say this sentence this way, no sooner do I finish this work, than then I shall begin another. It would be wrong, because with no sooner you have to use then. So no sooner do I finish the book, then I shall begin another. Hardly and scarcely should be followed by when or before, not by then or that. For example, hardly did I reach the station, then the train left it is wrong. Hardly did I reach the station when the train left it. Why? Because with hardly and scarcely, you have to use when and before and not then or that. As far as the use of preposition is concerned, the preposition is used after two words must be made clear if these two words are connected by and or. For example, if I say she is conscious and engaged in her work, then I need to use a preposition after conscious also, right? Otherwise, she is conscious of what? So the correct formation of sentence would be she is conscious of and engaged in her work. And why I used of with conscious? Because the preposition when used after two words must be made clear if these two words are connected by and or. Next is on, in, at are not used before today, tomorrow, yesterday, the following day or the next day. For example, he'll go there on tomorrow would be wrong. He'll go there tomorrow. On the contrary, if I am mentioning the name of some day, like he'll go there on Monday, right? So what we need to remember, that in case of today, tomorrow, yesterday, the following day, the next day, we don't have to use the preposition on, in, at, before them. No preposition is used before the word home. Students, don't be confused, because at times we say at home. At home is again a phrase which bears a different meaning. For example, if I say feel at home, here at home is a phrase, right? But if you are using home, you don't have to use a preposition before it. For example, if you say bring a TV set at home is wrong. You have to say bring a TV set home, right? I'll come back home, not I'll come back to home. After transitive verbs like discuss, describe, reach, order, tell, demand, attack, resemble, ridicule, etc., we directly use the object and no preposition is used after the verb. For example, if I say the poet describes about the beauty of nature in this poem, it is wrong. The poet describes the beauty of nature in this poem. Next, say, suggest, propose, speak, reply, explain, talk, listen, write is always followed by two preposition if there is a person in the form of object. And students, I have categorically mentioned these verbs for your perusal. So please go through them and understand them and don't forget to use two with them. For example, if I say he did not reply me, right? Now there is a person in the form of object, so we have to say he did not reply to me and not he did not reply me. Next, he did not write to a letter would be wrong because letter is not a person in the form of object. So he did not write a letter. I hope there is no confusion now. Let us talk about emphatic pronouns, right? Emphatic pronouns cannot stand alone as subjects. Right, emphatic pronouns need to have a subject of reference. For example, if I say himself did it is wrong. He himself did it because himself here is being used as an emphatic pronoun, so it needs to have a subject of reference. Next, the indefinite pronoun one should be used throughout if used at all. Right, like if I am saying one must not boast of his own success, I cannot use his with the indefinite pronoun one. It has to be used throughout if used at all. We need to remember. So one must not boast of one's own success. Either or neither is used only in speaking of two persons or things. Any, no one, and none is used in speaking of more than two. For example, any one of these two roads leads to the railway station. Right? So here I'm talking about two roads. So I have to use either and not anyone. Either of these two roads leads to the railway station. If I say neither of these three boys did his homework, now I'm talking about three boys, so I have to use no one and not neither. No one of these three boys did his homework. Each other is used in speaking of two persons or things. One another is used in speaking of more than two. For example, the two brothers loved one another is wrong. I'm talking about two brothers, so I have to use each other, right? That means while talking about two persons or things, we have to use each other. And while speaking of more than two, we have to use one another. We don't have to say the two brothers loved one another, but the two brothers loved each other. A pronoun must agree with its antecedent in person, number, and gender. Each of these three boys has done their homework is again wrong because we are using each, which is a single indefinite pronoun. So we have the right way to say the sentence would be each of these boys has done his homework. When two or more singular nouns are joined by and, the pronoun used for them must be in plural. For example, both Ravi and Raja have done his homework would be wrong. Now I'm talking about Ravi and Raja, and they have been joined by the conjunction and, so I have to take a different pronoun, right? I have to use a plural pronoun instead of a singular pronoun. So both Ravi and Raja have done their homework. When two or more plural pronouns of different persons come together, first person plural comes first, then second person plural, and last of all third person plural is used. For example, you, they, and we must work together. That would be the wrong way. So first we have to place first person plural pronoun, which is we, then second person plural pronoun, which is you, and last of all we will use third person plural pronoun, which is they. So the correct way to say this sentence would be we, you, and they must work together. With superlative degree adjective, only, none, all, etc. as relative pronouns, we use that and not which or who. For example, all which glitters is not gold is wrong. The right way to say the sentence is all that glitters is not gold. After let, if a pronoun is used, that pronoun must be in the objective case and not in the subjective case. For example, if I say let he go there is wrong. The right way to say this sentence would be let him go there. So students, these were the common errors which we make and which can be there in your verbal ability examination. So now please go through the rules once more. I hope the lecture must have been helpful for you. Thank you.